What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to show you how to turn your videos into a GIF.
It's GIF. It's GIF.
What?
Pronounced GIF.
Hold on. Let me check this out. Why are they spelled with a G? What's up, guys? In this video, I'm going to show you how to turn your videos into a GIF using Filmora. Now, what is a GIF? GIFs are highly compressed image sequences that loop endlessly or stop at the end of the sequence. Because of their high compression and low file size, they make it perfect for posting to the web. Now, I'm going to use Filmora, so if you want to follow along, you can try yours free by clicking on the link here or the description box below. I'm going to grab a cup of coffee while you do that. Where's all the sugar?
Well, you taught George how to make GIFs, so he's using all of it.
What? All right, so let's jump into Filmora, and I'm gonna show you how to make a GIF. So the first thing you wanna do is import your media files. So you can click on Import, Import Media Files. And I'm gonna bring my video file in here. And then what I'm going to do is drag and drop it down into the timeline. So there's parts of this clip that I don't want. So I'm going to trim parts of the beginning and parts of the end and get it a little shorter. And ideally with GIFs, the shorter the better, because then it keeps the file size down and then it will load faster and it will play back faster, so people don't have to wait to watch your funny GIF. So I'm going to cut right as his hand's coming up. I want to start right about there. I'll make a cut, and then I'm going to delete that first part of the clip. Then I'm going to go to the end, just before he starts to put his hand down. I'm going to make another cut, and then I'll delete that last part of the clip. So this video clip was shot in 60 frames per second, and that means I can slow it down. I'm going to double click on the clip and open up the edit menu, and then I'm going to slide the speed down just a bit more. There you go, that's good. So now I got about 5 seconds. That's a good length for a GIF. So I'm just going to play it back and watch it here. I'm going to make a cut at 4 seconds because I think that's long enough. I'm going to delete everything after the 4 second mark there where I made a cut. So now it's ready to be exported. So I'll click on export. So what you want to do is make sure that format is selected. And then if you go down the list of format, you can see just about at the bottom there is the GIF file format. So you want to click on GIF. Now you can name your file whatever you want. I'm going to call this Sugar Bay. And then you can save it to any destination. I'm going to choose the desktop. And then you want to go into settings. Now the encoder, you only have one option, so you don't have to worry about that. Now this footage was shot at 1920 by 1080. I'm actually going to lower it down. If you lower the resolution, the file size will be smaller. So again, your GIF will load faster and it'll play back faster, so people don't have to wait. So I'm going to go down to 640 by 360. And then with the frame rate, generally GIFs play at a lower frame rate. This will also help keep your file size small. So I suggest anywhere between 10 frames per second and 50 frames per second. If you choose something like 24 frames per second, that'll actually play back at real time. I find that a lot of funny GIFs have a bit of that time lapse or lag feeling to them. So for this one, I'm actually going to select 15 frames per second. Hit OK. And now it's ready to be exported. Right, and I'll open it up, and there it is. So now it's playing over and over. So that's how you can change your file format from a video to a GIF. Simple, right? So now I'm going to show you how to get a little more creative and make your GIF look like it's constantly in motion. So let's jump back into Filmora and I'll show you how. So for the creative GIF, first I want to take a snapshot. So I'm going to select my video clip in the media library here. I want to slide forward a bit, just as his hand's up. Right about there is good. So basically I'm going to use the right side of this photo. I want his body to be still. I want his head to be still. I want his body to be still. And the arm's going to move. So I'll hit the snapshot icon here. Now I'll drag and drop the snapshot into the main track. And then I'm gonna bring down my video file onto the picture-in-picture track. I want it to start when his hand's in the air. So I'm gonna find that part. And I like it here because all the sugar's coming down. So I'm gonna start around right about there. I'm gonna slide that over so it starts at the beginning of the video. And then I'm gonna trim this down to a point when the sugar stops coming out of his hand. Right about there is good. And then I'm gonna trim down the snapshot so they're the same length. So this is where it gets a little tricky. I'm gonna place a mask on the picture-in-picture track. So to be able to see this, I'm gonna toggle off the visibility on the main track by clicking the eyeball here. If I double-click on the picture-in-picture track and then hit advance, it'll open up the picture-in-picture editor and I have the mask tab open here. So I want this square mask and I'm gonna double click on it to activate it. Now I can change the width and you can see it's starting to cut out the edges. So what I wanna do is only be able to see his hand. So if I use the left slider here, I can slide that over. And then if I slide the width to the left, I can make sure that his head is out of the shot and his body. And then I'll hit OK. Now I have to toggle back on the visibility of the main track. And if I play it back, you'll see his hand is just moving, but his body is still. So it's really short, but what we can do now is export it as a GIF, and it will look like it's looping endlessly. So I'll hit export. I'll name it Sugar Bay 1. Save it to the desktop. My settings look good. 640 by 360 for resolution. This time, you know what, let's give 10 frames per second a shot. You can play around with the frame rate, like try 10, try 12, try 15, see what you like. So I'll hit export. I'll open up my GIF. And now you can see that George is in constant motion and using all of my sugar! GIFs are really popular for making memes, and in 2017 you may have seen a ton of them, you may have shared them with your friends and your family. So let us know in the comment section below what your favorite meme in 2017 was. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.